I began working towards designing the Magnum Opus in 2010. The process of creating a new ski can be a little slow at times. For me, it begins by sketching out different shapes and then building a to-scale version of the ski out of cardboard. And then I send it off to Jed Yeiser. He's the ski engineer that I work with at Lion Skis. The very first prototype of what would ultimately become this ski was actually radically different. Had super wide tip and tail. I got a version of this ski with a black Opus top sheet on it, and I took it to Japan. You can actually see the different tip shape that I was skiing in Japan in some of my GoPro shots. However, I found that the ski was just too specific. It didn't work incredibly well on hard pack. And at the same time, this wide tail, although it floated the tip really well, it dragged the tail down. The second version prototype that we created was a totally different ski from the first ski. We changed the dimensions entirely, and we changed the side cut and the tip shape. So basically, we started from scratch. In the spring of 2011, I got a version of this ski with the black Opus top sheet, and I brought it up to British Columbia for a level one shoot. And there I was really able to check it out. Immediately I noticed that the ski floated a lot better. I was still searching for the perfect tip shape, and so when I got home and after drawing a new tip shape on the tip, I just grinded it down and went up to the hill and skied it. You know, it's really amazing how you can take a ski that has the same flex, shape, waist width, length, and you just change one little thing about it, like the tip shape, and it skis completely different. The third version of the Magnum Opus prototype was a blend of the two previous versions. We took a side cut that was much more like the original Opus. We bumped out the waist to 124 mils and we created a length of 188 centimeters. I got my hands on this ski and I skied it throughout the holidays at my home mountain. The waist width, the length, the early taper, the early rise, the side cut, the camber and the flex. It was just a perfect balance. With the fourth prototype, we also started testing out different materials. And we started trying a core that was made out of balsa wood and flaxseed composite. It was amazing how well it skied with the added bonus of being much lighter. And so once again, I took my grinder and created some different tip shapes. The end result with the Magnum Opus is the most balanced powder ski that I've ever ridden. For the past decade, Lion Skis has allowed me to create any kind of ski that I could dream up. It's given me the license to take a different approach to ski design and build skis that allow me to draw a different line on the mountain. Lion has also given me total creative freedom to design whatever ski graphic I want. This graphic is based on the mountain I learned to ski on, Mount Hood, where I still live today. It's a lone peak with an imagined route system. I wanted to try to draw a mountain much like an iceberg, with 10% above the water and 90% below the water. I started out sketching a few mountains in my book, finally figured out a technique, and drew a very large pencil on paper drawing. It took me a few days. My hand was pretty well destroyed by the time I was finished, but it turned out really well. I wanted to see what it would look like in color, so I also did an oil painting of the same mountain. For me, the art symbolizes where I'm rooted to, my home, my family, and my beginnings as a skier. It's my favorite graphic to date, and it's on the best ski I've ever designed.